This is a temperature scanner I built. I was having some problems with overheating on my Duramax, so I built this 6 temperature probe scanner. You can see it's updating about every second. I actually have the name of where I was going to put the sensors. There was an ambient temperature intake. Basically, I just put them all around the truck and under the hood and got to some good data out of this. This over here is actually a timer because I wanted to kind of keep track of how long the program was running. So you can just reset power and the timer restarts. So temperature 6 is actually 46. Here I'm going to grab a random probe and warm it up. This is obviously the top one. These are just little thermistors. They're like 50 cents each. The screen is one of these Nokia LCD screens in a Radio Shack project box. I happen to have a connector that I put on it, so it's easy to disconnect. And actually scaled the transistors out here with resistors. It's a little bit ugly, but the cool thing is these are just raw analogs, so you can repurpose this and plug whatever you want in to these analogs. It doesn't have to be temperature sensors. In the back of the box is very simple: power switch, battery, Arduino, and LCD screen, and our analog inputs coming in. The LCD screen is a PDC 8544, and that's the Philips chip that drives the little display. I got one from IT Studio that already had header pins soldered on, or you can get the same exact one from SparkFun. It doesn't have the pins. The screen was commonly used in Nokia phones, the 3310 and 5510, so if you're searching for code for these screens, you'll often find it under those numbers, not the PDC number. They only run about $8 to $10. The Arduino Pro Mini, the 3-volt version, just so you get an idea of size. So the reason I went with this is because it's a 3-volt version. This LCD screen is 3 volts, and if you want to use a regular Duramax Nova to run it, you have to step it down voltages, control voltages, from 5 volts to 3 volts, either using resistors or a... I went ahead and soldered header pins on here so I can use my FTDI programming cable. I'm just coming off of pins 3 through 7, the discrete pins, coming over here to these inputs on the those 5 lines going into the LCD screen. These two are power, and there's one if I wanted the LCD backlight. So in my air box, I put my sensor right here to get the intake temperature, called grill temperature. So I'm checking the temperature of the air coming in here. My hood temp is getting the temperature of the air coming right out of the fan here. Then I have one for after cooler temp, and this is strapped down, touching the after cooler pipe. Not very scientific. And for my ambient air temp, I just brought it back here. My ambient temp says 69. This one says 77. So my temperatures may be 10 degrees low, but they're gonna help give me a good idea anyway.